Welcome. My name is Molly Horseman, and I'm a faculty member at the VA Quality Scholars Coordinating Center at the Michael E. DeBakey VA Medical Center. This Methods and Analysis mini-module was developed in conjunction with VAC's Methods and Analysis faculty, Dr. Susie Miltner and Dr. Brant Oliver. This mini-module will provide an introduction to variation and run charts. Understanding variation is a core concept in healthcare improvement and one that we will be returning to frequently in the VA Quality Scholars curriculum. Run charts are a foundational tool for analyzing time-ordered data in healthcare improvement work. Run charts are simple, but they are also one of the easiest and most economical approaches for analyzing data over time. Edward Stemming was an early leader in the use of statistical methods to improve quality in industry. One of his obsessions was variation, reducing unwanted variation, and understanding appropriate variation. He encouraged organizations to reduce statistically significant variation and to not overreact to slight changes in the system, which are often expected, predictable, and appropriate. When organizations focus on results alone without understanding variation, they run the risk of wasting time and resources trying to improve processes that are stable. By examining both results and variation together, organizations stand a much better chance of focusing their time and resources on areas that would benefit from improvement efforts. This sentiment is encompassed in this quote from Edward Stemming. If I had to reduce my message for management to just a few words, I'd say it all had to do with reducing variation. Let's look at a conceptual example of variation. On this slide, we see the results of 10 darts thrown by Mary and Bill. As you can see, Mary's darts are all clustered together. Although she does not hit the bullseye, she has little variation. Bill hits the bullseye, but his darts are spread out across the target. For Mary to improve, she only has to adjust her throw down and to the left. Then her darts should all be clustered at the bullseye. Bill has much more work to do to reduce his variation. Here's another example of variation using free throws. Although Mary's free throws do not result in points, she has little variation in her shots and may become an excellent free throw shooter with a few modifications to her shot. Bill, on the other hand, occasionally gets the ball through the hoop, but will have much more work to do to become consistent. Often in healthcare, we encounter people who will make decisions about which processes and outcomes require improvement based on a single data point and assume that that single data point represents the system's performance. As this example shows, it is important to examine data over time to get a true idea of whether the performance seen is acceptable. One of the easiest ways to examine variation within a system is a run chart. A run chart consists of data that is plotted over time with a line of central tendency. For run charts, the line of central tendency is the median value of the data. The median is the midpoint of the distribution of observed values. The x-axis is time. Although we typically think of time-ordered data as being days, weeks, months, or quarters, time-ordered data can also include any sequential measures, such as the clinic wait time for sequential patients or sequential blood glucose levels for a single patient. The y-axis is the variable of interest that you are measuring. Run charts are simple and can be created easily by hand or with Excel. They are also a powerful analytical tool that allows improvement teams to identify statistically significant changes, either improvement or degradation, in system performance. There are three steps to analyzing a run chart. First, you need to review the median performance of the system and determine if the median value is clinically acceptable. For example, if you are in a primary care clinic, it is unacceptable for your median value for the percentage of eligible patients receiving colon cancer screening to be 50%. The second step is to measure the maximum range or precision. The maximum range is the difference between the highest point and the lowest point. Precision is important. You may have a process where the median is acceptable, but where there is a wide range in the data points, resulting in performance that looks very different week to week or month to month. The final step is to identify the variation type. When we talk about variation, there are two types of variation that we look for: common cause variation, which is the variation that occurs by chance, and special cause variation, which is a statistically significant change in system performance. Once again, common cause variation is variation that happens by chance alone. This type of variation is sometimes called random variation. This variation does not represent a statistically significant change. A Unfortunately, people often get excited about single point changes in data without recognizing that the single point change represents random variation. At times, this results in individuals tampering with a system that was actually stable. One example of common cause variation is your commute to work. Although your commute may vary day to day, the variation is often predictable and depends on things like traffic lights and parking. Special cause variation is non-random variation that can be attributed to an assignable cause. Special cause variation is a statistically significant change in the performance of the system. For our work commute example, we've all experienced situations where there is a non-random variation in our commute time from an assignable cause, such as a flat tire, road closure, or bad weather. One of the questions we often get from individuals who are new to healthcare improvement is whether common cause or special cause variation should be considered good or bad variation. And the answer is that it depends. Common cause variation does not necessarily mean it is good variation. Common cause variation means that the performance of the system is stable. Imagine that you have a patient who has a systolic blood pressure that ranges between 160 and 170. Just because the blood pressure is stable does not mean that the blood pressure is desirable. Special cause variation does not necessarily mean that it is bad variation. Special cause variation means that the performance is unstable. This lack of stability may be a good thing. If your patient has started on a new blood pressure medication and now consistently has a systolic blood pressure between 120 and 130, this special cause variation is desirable, and you would want to continue that blood pressure medication. In summary, both common cause variation and special cause variation offer opportunities to learn about system performance. This knowledge of the process helps you decide if the output of the process is acceptable. Next, we are going to review three probability-based rules for interpreting run charts for common cause and special cause variation. Although there are many rules that have been developed to analyze run charts, our focus will be on the three basic rules that you will apply most often. Each of these rules are probability-based, and if identified in your run chart, indicate that there is a statistically significant change in system performance. The three rules we are going to discuss are shifts, trends, and having too few or too many runs. Shifts are six or more consecutive points, either all above or all below the median. Points that are on the median do not add to or break a shift. Shifts are a robust method for identifying statistically significant change in a system. The likelihood of having six consecutive points all above or all below the median corresponds to a p-value of 0.03. Trends are five or more consecutive points all going up or all going down. If the value of two or more consecutive points is the same, only count the first point and ignore repeating values. Runs are one or more consecutive points on the same side of the median. For this rule, you will be examining your run chart to see if there are too few or too many runs compared to the probability-based expected number of runs based on the number of usable data points. It is important to note that you only need one of these rules to be positive to have special cause variation. Both the shift and run rules require your chart to have a median. Experts recommend that you have at least 10 data points to establish a median on a run chart. Next, we are going to go through each of the rules individually. This run chart provides an example of a shift. As you can see, there are 8 consecutive points that are all below the median, which means that there was a statistically significant change in the process. This run chart provides an example of a trend. As you can see, there are 6 consecutive points that are decreasing. Note that there are 2 points in the trend that have the same value. Remember that only the first point is counted towards the number of points needed for a trend. Shifts and trends are both easy to use as they require only visual inspection of the run chart. To use the probability-based rule for runs, there are 2 steps that you must take. The first step is to count the number of usable data points. The number of usable data points is the number of data points that are not on the median. In this case, we have 31 data points and 2 that fall on the median. This gives us a total of 29 usable data points. The second step is to count the number of runs. A run is one or more points on one side of the median. Remember that points on the median do not count towards a run. In this chart, we have circled the runs. Note that on the fifth run, the point on the median is not counted and does not break the run. An easy way to count the number of runs is to count the number of times the line connecting points actually crosses the median and add 1. As you can see in this example, the line connecting the points crosses the median 9 times, giving us 10 runs. Now that you know the number of usable data points and the number of runs, you need to use a reference table to determine the number of runs that would be expected based on random variation. The reference table can be found in the readings for this mini module. As you will recall, we had 29 usable data points, which means we would expect to have between 10 and 20 runs with random variation. We have 10, which means that by the number of runs rule, this run chart has common cause variation. Run charts will only tell you if change has happened. It will not tell you what caused the change. Annotation is one way to help readers understand the attributable causes for a change in performance. As you can see in this example, there was an improvement in the 30-day readmission rate following the introduction of a dedicated discharge navigator for high-risk patients, and that these improvements went away when the program was expanded to all patients and the workload of the discharge navigator increased. Once you have analyzed your chart and identified the type of variation, the next step is to decide what to do. You may be in a situation where you have identified special cause variation and have an unstable system. If the change is desirable, your goal will be to understand the assignable causes to maximize, optimize, replicate, and standardize. If the change is negative, your goal will be to understand the assignable causes to minimize or eliminate these causes. Once you change the system, you may get to a state where the performance is stable and you have common cause variation. If your system is stable, it is important to consider whether your precision and your median performance is acceptable. If you have a lot of variation, you will want to work to make the process more reliable and increase the precision. If the median performance is unacceptable, you will want to redesign the process to get a better result. Both of these actions may eventually lead to a system with special cause variation. As you go through your improvement work, you will encounter this cyclical pattern. The important thing is to recognize what can be learned from special cause and common cause variation to make improvements in a system.